Well, first things first, I'm going to play a little clip for you today on how to easily transfer your worthless paper money into a valuable cryptocurrency. You'll see right here. And actually, you're going to have to forgive me because this was filmed on an old phone because I have my Bitcoin wallet on my new phone. So I wasn't going to switch everything back over just to take a video on my new phone. So it's all kind of like weirdly videoed, and I had to really normalize the sound and really change it a lot. So you're going to have to bear with me here really quick. So sorry. Hello everybody, Crypto Chaperone here, and today I'm going to be showing you how to turn any of this basic useless paper money that you may be having laying around. I'm going to show you how to turn this worthless junk into actually something useful, a future valuable asset called a Bitcoin, and I'm going to show you how easy it is right now.
Okay, so this is a Bitcoin ATM, and this gives you the options to buy Bitcoins, withdraw Bitcoins, or redeem Bitcoins with an already named wallet that you could scan. So today we're going to be buying Bitcoins. So we're going to click buy. It'll ask you what you want to buy. It'll tell you at the top what the current prices are that they are selling it for. And you click what you're going to buy. Today we're going to be buying $1 to $1,500 worth. It will then ask you to put in your phone number. This is a basic know your client stage that it will, normal Bitcoin ATMs will make you put this in. After you put in your phone number, it will send you a verification code to prove that the phone is yours. If it is the first time that you are entering the phone code, your phone number, you may have to scan your license, and that would be your know your client. At this point, you would either scan whether you want it to be sent via an address or if you want to scan a wallet code. You'll scan the wallet code. Now we will take our wallet. We will hold it directly under the laser where it tells you. It's just like shown. It will scan. It will ask if this is your wallet to protect you from any phishing. And then all you have to do is insert your money down here. And then once you enter all the money you want, it's as easy as clicking finish. And the transaction will then be sent to your wallet. It will then ask you if you would like to print a receipt.
Wow, that was deep. But aside from the message, it's a really quick way for you to transfer your paper money into Bitcoins if you do want to invest in this future asset that I think is going to take off soon. Possibly investing $500 now could lead you into being $5,000 or $10,000 in the future. So it's definitely something you might want to look into. Today I'm just going to do a really quick look at the markets. I've been looking into ICOs and stuff lately. I've been having a lot of people ask me about a lot of ICOs, so I've been kind of looking into those, dabbling a little bit every day into something different in the ICO world. I'm trying not to take in too much of one all at once because it'll make me kind of biased on them. So I'm kind of just grabbing little bits and little bits every day, reading through, and then I'm going to go back and kind of really hit them hard all at once, one by one, and break it down. And if I see anything that's kind of worth making a video about, I'll make a video. Other than that, I'll just reply to you guys kind of one by one as you're asking me questions, that I kind of feel how I feel personally about the ICOs. So other than that, just a quick look at today. Bitcoin, pretty stable around 5,700. As we can see, we've got a kind of nice plateau right here. So anything's really kind of possible here. That means that the money is not really going into Bitcoin. I think people are kind of stopping and looking and wondering what they're going to get into next. I think everybody was kind of assuming altcoins were going to massively drop, and they did drop, and now they're kind of going up a little. And I think people are kind of wondering where they're going to put their money next, if they're going to keep it in Bitcoin for a further spike or they're going to pull it out for altcoins. As we saw earlier today, we had the Byzantium fork. I think that went through. And Ethereum is now down 2% after that. It's kind of following the same exact trend as Bitcoin. It kind of has the plateauing effect right up here. Other than that, you have your third coin of the market cap today is Ripple. And this has actually kind of moved up in the market cap because if you've been paying any attention, Bank of America, an analyst from Bank of America, actually released a write-up about why cryptocurrencies could possibly be good in the future. And it went through and it detailed a few cryptocurrencies and kind of just all about them. And I feel like that's why we're seeing kind of a spike in the market caps in some of these, like Ripple. If you look at the 24-hour change, Stellar Lumen, they're kind of like a micro payment processor, and they're kind of working with the bank, trying to work with the banking system. That's why I kind of think they're boosting a lot right now, because of the whole news of the banking system. Bank of America is really, I feel like, behind cryptocurrencies after this, and this is going to be a huge pump of money coming in. As soon as Bank of America gets in, other banks are going to want to follow. They're not going to want to fall behind. Another top gainer today, we have Gnosis. Gnosis is a predictive market coin, so it's definitely had a random pump for some reason. I haven't really looked into that too much. Just a lot of coins are kind of pumping today. NEM as well. I've kind of noticed that NEM follows Ripple. When I first invested in Ripple, I also invested in NEM. They kind of like came hand in hand when I was doing my research, and they both kind of had booms at the same time. So anytime that Ripple does have any sort of a spike, I always like to keep an eye on NEM as well. I don't really invest in it, but it does see some spikes as well, so I may start to look into that a little bit more and take advantage of those spikes as they do happen. Other than that, on our down tokens, we have our Mona coin still taking reaping a little bit of profits. People are trading now that it hit that Japanese Flyer BTC exchange. Enigma token that was actually just released, like I think a week ago, it was sent to people who did invest in it, and it was released from the storage, and people were able to trade it. Centra, kind of just a card that I think Centra is the same as like a 10x. It's a card that will just transfer your cryptocurrencies into a fiat. Pretty much you could use it as a card and it would transfer your cryptocurrency into a fiat of whatever the payment would cost in real time. So if you had something that would cost $5.96 and you had $50 of cryptocurrency on your card, you could pay for it in your cryptocurrencies, and it would transfer your cryptocurrency from $50 in Bitcoin or Ethereum into $5.96 in US dollars or euros or whatever you're paying in, and it would automatically pay for it. That's how the 10x works, and I'm fairly sure I think that's how the Centra and the whole that whole card space works. It's pretty cool. I am actually looking into getting a 10x card possibly. I'm not really into spending my straight up cryptos, because I'm kind of in them for trading and holding, and I don't want to cash them out into paper money, but possibly it'd be cool just to make maybe a video about it or something like that. Populous token is also taking one of the biggest hits of the day, 42% down. But other than that, we don't see any really major hits. Market's looking fairly healthy, $174 billion market cap today, hovering around that for the past couple days. And Bitcoin dominance, 54.6%. It's been hovering around 54% for, I think, 2 days now. It just got a little bit of a boost last week from the low 50s up into about 54%. So we'll see how that fluctuates coming closer to the BTC Gold forking coming up. And other than that, I hope you guys enjoyed my how to transfer your worthless money into something that could be valuable in the future, and potentially as that worthless money becomes more and more worthless, you might be losing out on an opportunity to invest in something that's becoming more and more valuable. So you might want to take that opportunity now before later. Other than that, all I can say is go out and look for more cryptocurrency videos and do as much research as you can and watch more great YouTube cryptocurrency enthusiasts and teachers and try to learn as much as you can about this space. Because every day is ever-changing, and you can never learn too much about it. And I hope you guys have a great day. Thanks for watching.